Please join me in welcoming the College of Pharmacy, Class of 2026. Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Janine Winicky, and I'm the Associate Dean for Student Affairs here at the College of Pharmacy. And along with other members of the College of Pharmacy who are here today, it is my pleasure to welcome all of you to the White Coat Ceremony for the Class of 2026 at Rosalind Franklin University. This is a significant and meaningful event, which is enhanced by all of you who have chosen to join us this afternoon. We want to thank all of you, the family and friends of the Class of 2026, who are here in person or via live stream. I know that your overall support means a great deal to your students today. We're also appreciative of members of the Rosalind Franklin community being here, faculty, staff, and students from our program. Thank you. And finally, we'd like to thank Jewel Osco and Christy Bruneman, whose gift of the white coats and the reception is greatly appreciated. We appreciate that all of you have made the effort to come together today to celebrate this truly symbolic event for the Class of 2026. The symbolism begins for you, the Class of 2026, as this ceremony represents your transition from a strictly didactic education to one that includes clinical training and activities. The acceptance of the white coat indicates your entry into the world of patient care and the next step in your evolution as student pharmacists. The symbolism extends to the College of Pharmacy itself. For just as the white coat signifies your metamorphosis, today's ceremony also represents the college's responsibility of preparing you for the changing role of pharmacy in healthcare and providing pharmacy practices experiences for each of you, our 12th entering class. It's an exciting time for all of us, and everyone in this auditorium should feel proud to be a part of the beginning of this journey ahead. At this time, I would like to introduce Dr. Scott Haynes, Interim Dean of the College of Pharmacy. Dr. Haynes will offer some opening remarks. Dr. Haynes.
Thank you so much, Dean Winicky. Welcome, and first and foremost, congratulations again to the Class of 2026. As this is the first regularly scheduled white coat ceremony that we're having in person, in 3 years, believe me, I can say that we're as thrilled about today as you are. Welcome as well to family and friends. Their support and guidance helped you to reach this day, and we're very pleased that you all could join us. As Dean Winicky mentioned, today's ceremony is largely symbolic, symbolizing your entry into the profession, beginning of your journey to becoming a pharmacist. It's a very exciting time, and you should be excited as you begin this turning point in your career. The motivations to enter the career of pharmacy are various, and I'm sure you all have your own individual motivations, but I would hope that includes a deep desire to help people with their health care and wellness as the expert in drug therapy. And I want to repeat, the expert in drug therapy. That is your role. Today, you will take the first steps towards that goal, and in 4 short years, as a doctor of pharmacy, you will be bestowed the honor and responsibility of that care. 3 years ago, at approximately the same time, the same ceremony, our former dean, Dr. Abel, who is now retired, highlighted a few applicable words to characterize the moment. These included transition, change, and growth. Certainly, these are all still very appropriate, but take on a new context, in a sense, now coming out of, I'm going to put quotation marks, post-pandemic. I know we're not quite there, but I'm optimistic. First, transition. Today, you begin a transition from undergraduate to graduate student as a healthcare professional. It is a different animal. You will hear that many different times throughout the course of orientation and future weeks. And you will need to adjust to that. And there's no shame in doing that. Regardless of your previous successes, there will be some adjustments that are needed by everybody. So family and friends, please support them as they work through those adjustments. You will also transition into the clinical portion of your PharmD journey, where you will interact with real patients and healthcare professionals solving real problems. Post-pandemic, what does this look like? The pharmacist has transitioned from simply being an option for immunization as an immunization provider to serving at the forefront of the fight against COVID-19. If you're not already aware, pharmacists have provided approximately 70% of the vaccinations to eligible patients. That is huge. Wouldn't have been done without our significant role. So you will continue to play a pivotal role, vital role in these efforts and additional efforts that will come forth. Changes. Although change is constant in the healthcare environment, your PharmD training comes at a particularly interesting and important time. Look no further than the recent Supreme Court decision to overturn Roe versus Wade. Once perceived as a given right, the ruling poses a continued threat to unravel the nature of our role in reproductive health care. You will be part of this as pharmacy initiates and responds to the evolution of health care and your important role as an advocate for not only your profession, but for your patients. Growth, last but not least. Your personal and professional growth over the next 4 years will be exponential, and you probably won't even realize it. Fueled by acquisition of foundational knowledge, clinical science knowledge and skills, and the confidence that comes with it, year to year, you will look and you will behave differently. I see it throughout the halls. I know our faculty see it as well. Indeed, what is happening is you are becoming a healthcare professional. A significant but often overlooked factor in your professional development is, in fact, the community, the environment, where we're at now. Just as your personality has been developed and shaped by your home environment, family, friends over time, your professional personality, if you will be shaped by your professors, your fellow students, hallway interactions, office chats, things of that nature. While we all appreciate the benefits and convenience of working remote and maybe even learning remote, there is no substitute for the benefit of in-person community. As I mentioned earlier, today is largely symbolic. In a little while, you'll start your journey by putting on your white coat. Take a moment to consider that your white coat symbolizes you as a healthcare professional. As a pharmacist, you can greatly impact people's lives as caring and competent professionals. You have bright futures ahead of you and no doubt will make your family, your community, your faculty, and yourself very proud. After 4 short years, and believe me, it will fly by much quicker than you think, you will be more than ready to enter the profession as a practice-ready, skilled clinician advancing the health of your patients as part of a healthcare team. I welcome you, and I applaud you for making the decision to enter this rewarding and wonderful profession. Best of luck to you on your journey. Congratulations again. It is now my pleasure to introduce Dr. Lauren Angelo, Associate Dean for Academic Affairs at the College of Pharmacy, for bestowing of the white coats.
Thank you, Dr. Haynes. Those were very inspiring, wonderful remarks. Class of 2026, it is an honor and a privilege to be part of your white coat ceremony today. Dr. Kathy Patel, who's an associate professor in the Department of Pharmacy Practice, and Dr. Walters, who's a professor in the Pharmaceutical Sciences Department, will be coding you this afternoon. As I read the names, please hold your applause until all names have been read. Aya Abdelhadi. Zakira Akbari. Oluwatobi Akinsonya. Dina Alrawi. Crystal Aponte. Rachel Asakun. Marilena Barbanente. Devante Cocroft. Madison Bierman. Marissa Fearman. Shamiram Gabriel. Stefan Marcus Gilas. Alexandra Guzek. Nadia Jarumi. Eddie Lopez. Christian McCoy. Denise Morales. Ni Nguyen Tha. Clara Olivares. Diamond Owens. Kathleen Padilla. Janice Pokua. Tiffany Prada. Thomas Ravenko. Pablo Rosario Albert. Maxwell Shewi. Monica Sosani. Andrew Tenner. Congratulations to our student pharmacists in the class of 2026. I will now ask that Dr. Andrew Romero, a graduate of the college's class of 2022, provide a few words of wisdom and lead us in the candle lighting ceremony followed by the oath of the pharmacist. Dr. Romero received his Bachelor's of Science from University of Wisconsin-Parkside and his Doctor of Pharmacy from Rosalind Franklin University in 2002. While at RFU, Andrew was very involved on campus, holding leadership positions at both the college and the university level. He was the class of 2022 representative for the college's assessment and evaluation committee. He was president of the Student National Pharmaceutical Association, and Andrew served as president of the university's executive student council during the 2020-2021 academic year. Dr. Romero was the recipient of the College of Pharmacy's Outstanding Student Leadership Award in 2022. Upon graduation, Dr. Romero was accepted to the Advocate Aurora Health Residency Program at Condell Medical Center in Libertyville, Illinois. His experiences there support a full range of services to patients in the North Chicago suburbs. Please welcome Dr. Romero.
Thank you, Dean Angelo. I'll ask that you all refer to me as Andrew. I'm not yet used to the doctor title. Thank you for the invitation to speak to you all today. I want to say good afternoon to the class of 2026 and all the loving friends and family who came to celebrate this special day together, including those who are watching us this afternoon. Today, I've been graciously invited by Dean Winicky to speak to you all near the closing of today's white coat ceremony as an alumni, a recent graduate of the College of Pharmacy. If you're a faculty member and had the unfortunate pleasure of listening to me the last time I gave a speech on campus, you'll know firsthand that 2 years in the Zoom and Google Meets era has done me no favors. Any public speaking skills I had prior to COVID are now gone, and any ability I may have had to speak to my webcam does not translate well to this stage. Rest assured, you do not have to suffer for too long. My purpose in standing before you today is not to highlight my pharmacy career or speak on any past accomplishments. I'm not going to tell you best study practices or how to easily complete your most difficult classes. Instead, I'd like to share with you 4 brief pearls of wisdom in the form of things I wish I had done, or at the very least, wish I had done better. Number 1, be mindful of your reputation. What others think of you matters. The people sitting next to you today will not always be your classmates. The people sitting on the stage will not always be your professors. Eventually, they will be coworkers, mentors, employers, and even close friends. You'll come to see that pharmacy, no matter your chosen field of practice or your institution, is a very small world. And the faces you come to know here will continue to appear long after you graduate. That means that the relationships that you develop will be critical to your experience as a pharmacist after you graduate. Whenever you face conflict or adversity, keep this reality in the front of your mind. Number 2, do not study with the intention of passing an exam. Study with the intention of treating a patient. The lessons you learn while a student at this university have very real implications in the actual world. Studying just to score high marks and make it to the next exam may seem like the most logical reason to study. Why else put in all the time and effort? The reason is someday that test question won't just be a score or a percentage. It will be a patient. It will be someone's mother or father, someone's child or their parent, a spouse or a widow. In that moment, your expertise and knowledge may very well be the final factor that determines if someone gets the treatment they need and recovers. For this reason, you should always seek to first learn as much as possible for the sake of practicing to the best of your abilities. Good grades will follow. Number 3, you cannot hope to take care of others if you haven't first taken care of yourself. You're here to learn and to grow, to succeed and to sometimes fail. Your education will cost you time. It will cost you sleep. It will cost you energy and comfort. It may cost you friendships and relationships. I don't think I have to mention money. The one thing it shouldn't cost is your health. There will come a time where you are simply struggling, days where you wake up and instantly feel as if the weight of the world is on your shoulders. Days when you're just not sure if you can really do it all, or when you're absolutely sure that you can't. When that moment comes, you need to be honest and say, I'm not okay, I need help. And trust that the people in this auditorium and those on this stage will be there for you. They were for me. In the same way that your patients will need a team of providers to care for them, so too should you rely on the expertise and assistance of others in your time of need. Final, number 4. Pharmacy school will be over before you know it. Appreciate it while it's here. What you'll hear often over the next 4 years is just how fast time goes by. Several years ago, I read a written piece by one Miss Emma Phillips. Phillips, a retired American school teacher, wrote her own obituary shortly after being diagnosed with terminal cancer to describe her experience with life and just how fleeting it is. To this day, I haven't found a written piece that so perfectly exemplifies how fleeting time truly is. Published in her local newspaper and eventually national publications, she wrote, quote, I was born, I blinked, and it was over.
No buildings named after me, no monuments erected in my honor, but I did have the chance to know and love each and every friend as well as all my family members. How much more blessed can a person be? Ladies and gentlemen, I sat in your same seat not too long ago. Just like Ms. Phillips, I blinked and it was over. Before long, one of you will also blink and find yourself behind the same podium, welcoming the newest generations of future pharmacists into their academic careers. I hope that on that day you feel as excited and hopeful for them as I do for all of you. I want to thank you one last time for the opportunity to speak to you all and be able to share this special moment this afternoon. Congratulations to the class of 2026 on one of the first big steps towards your career as a doctor of pharmacy. We'll now continue the symbolism of today's ceremony with the lighting of candles. Class of 2026, please stand. P2s, class of 2025, please light your own candles and share with class of 2026 students at the end of each roll who will pass the flame towards the middle. The flame of these candles represents the knowledge that is both accepted by you during your training and passed on from you to your patients and colleagues as you continue your career. Today, your candles are lighted by members of the classes of 2025, led by the student dean, Susan Smock. Next year, you will be able to light the candles of the class of 2027, and so we maintain the tradition of sharing and giving that will continue well into the future. We will now recite the pharmacist's oath together. Any pharmacy professionals in the audience who would like to join us, please stand and recite the oath along with the class of 2026. The oath can be found on the back page of the program. We will recite it together. I promise to devote myself to a lifetime of service to others through the profession of pharmacy. In fulfilling this vow, I will consider the welfare of humanity and relief of suffering my primary concerns. I will promote inclusion, embrace diversity, and advocate for justice to advance health equity. I will apply my knowledge, experience, and skills to the best of my ability to assure optimal outcomes for all patients. I will respect and protect all personal and health information entrusted to me. I will accept the responsibility to improve my professional knowledge, expertise, and self-awareness. I will hold myself and my colleagues to the highest principles of our profession's moral, ethical, and legal conduct. I will embrace and advocate changes that improve patient care. I will utilize my knowledge, skills, experiences, and values to prepare the next generation of pharmacists. I take these vows voluntarily with the full realization of the responsibility with which I am entrusted by the public. Please blow out the candles. I'd like to ask Dean Nwendike to share closing remarks.
Thanks. Oh, Andrew, you're going to bring tears to my eyes, Dr. Romero. It's been a pleasure watching him grow and develop over the last 4 years, and just knowing the class of 2026 for the last 3 days, I can already feel my heart looking forward to watching you graduate in a few short 4 years. This does bring us to the close of today's ceremony, and I really would like to congratulate each of you on your choice to join the profession and RFU's class of 2026. We're really proud of you and so excited to welcome you here into the profession. Thank you again, Dr. Romero, for your inspiring words, and thank you for taking part of this wonderful occasion. We also want to again thank Jewel Osco, their representative, Christy Bruneman, for all of your support over the many years that we've held this event. This event does take a lot of planning, and I want to thank the College of Pharmacy faculty and staff for all of their input and assistance. I'd like to thank Dawn Schoen, without which this ceremony could not have occurred, as well as to Ted Gavlin, Marion Hughes, and Lisa Mishner for their assistance throughout the afternoon, as well as our orientation advisors for their assistance all throughout the week and today. I also want to acknowledge the guidance and help given by members of our university student affairs office, Shelley Briswicki, Mariana Gibbs, Eric Bocelli, Christian Kopp, Alonda Oliveira, and Shelby Farley. Also, thank you in the back to Jeff Lang, Mike Schmidt for videography and photography of this event, and to Cliff Turner, our AV expert. I know I never have to worry with this group behind our event each and every year. And finally, I do want to recognize our Midwest Young Artist Quartet. Thank you so much for helping make the celebration special. I grew up playing the viola, so I love to hear the music. Ruth Kim, Vincenzo Zupardio on violins, Dylan Ivanovov on viola, and Jocelyn Gao cello. And then as we wrap up, I just have a couple of announcements as well as housekeeping notes. Friends and family, you really are invited to an upcoming virtual event to help you learn what pharmacy school is going to be like for your friend or family member. You may have received information about it as you walked in, or there will be information about it as you leave. The event is scheduled for next week. It's hosted by the College of Pharmacy as well as students. They really just help you learn what pharmacy school is going to be like for your friend or family member, hear advice, and review an overview of the curriculum so you kind of know what your student's going through over the next few years. So feel free to look at that information. Your student has it as well if you'd like to learn more. And then finally, the class of 2026, they're going to be staying in the auditorium briefly for some class pictures, and they will join the guests shortly at a small reception that we're having right outside in the courtyard. Our university student affairs and faculty and staff can help guide you, as well as signs. The reception is outdoors just to respect the university's policy for masking inside, so we'd ask that you enjoy the food and drink outside. And a photographer will also be available to take some pictures of you, your family, your classmates, et cetera. So take advantage of that opportunity. And then finally, I just have two short activities for us to do before we leave the auditorium. Class of 2026, I'd like you to rise, stand, turn and face your family and friends. Let's give them a big thank you for all of their encouragement and support. And now I would like to ask everyone in the auditorium to please stand and congratulate the class of 2026 with another round of applause. Thank you very much. Students will join you in the Scholl Gallery area shortly. I want to thank everyone for being here. Safe travels, and I'll meet you outside at the reception. Thanks again.